Good morning, YouTube family, and welcome back to my channel. So today, I'm going to be bringing you guys along a full body at home workout. I'm happy to share that it is going to be one of the last few workouts that I will be doing at home now that my gym is going to be reopening next week. It is where I do my one-on-one personal training. So I'm so relieved that I'm gonna have all the equipment I need to make sure I'm following my program again. And that's 7 weeks to really give it my all and crush the rest of this prep. Also in this video, I'm gonna be showing you what I like to get during my weekly grocery runs and how I bulk prep my meals for the week. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy and stay tuned. Well, hopefully the gyms will be opening up next week, so I'm enjoying the last few home workouts here. And today I have a special guest joining me. Meet my boyfriend, Danny.
Hello, how's it going?
And we're gonna take you through a killer home full body workout, and let's get to it. Before we start our workout today, we're going to be taking 1UP Nutrition pre-workout. Today's flavor is Island Mango. You got your water?
Yeah, I got a little bit.
All right, ready? Are you ready? Let's do it.
All right, next workout is a bench press, supersetted with leg extensions. If your gym doesn't have one of these, I feel bad for you. Don't do that.
So that concludes our full body workout. How'd you feel?
It was good. I went a little lighter on the legs because I hit my yearly leg workout the other day, so I was still a little bit sore from that, but other than that, it was good.
Yeah, so that concludes the workout. I do have cardio that's a sign I'm gonna do later on in the day. And now I'm gonna show you guys our Trader Joe's haul, showing you guys what I usually get when I am prepping, and yeah. I am currently 8 weeks out from my WBFF Dallas show, and being closer to the show, I make sure that all of my food choices are whole foods, making sure that I'm getting lean protein, enough of the vegetables, and really hitting my nutrition targets and macro targets to a T. So I'm gonna show you guys how I do that. I do like to get smaller grocery hauls. I don't like to do like bulk shopping as much, just because I like to get them, especially like the meat and my protein sources, a little fresher. And sometimes when I get like my produce, I want that to be fresh as well. So for this week's grocery run, I went to Trader Joe's. So I really like Trader Joe's because they have a wide variety selection of the frozen foods that I like to get. So let's get right into it. So first off, I'm going to show you guys my protein sources that I like to get. So I like to get these frozen chicken strips. They're already cooked. All you got to do is heat them and eat them. This is really great when I am in a rush or don't really have the time to cook, but I need to get my protein in. And I like to toss them on salads with my rice and veggies and stuff like that. I have this oven roasted turkey breast. So with deli meats like this, I make sure that I get lean meats. And this is really easy because I could throw it on rice cakes or on some toast, or even eat it like this with like cucumbers or some veggies. Again, this is crucial for when I'm trying to hit my protein. Next, I got these wild tuna packets. So tuna is one of my favorite like quick and easy protein fixes. This whole packet has about 22 grams of protein. I like to put this also on rice cakes or make like a tuna sandwich. Again, super easy, toss them in the fridge, toss them in my bag when I'm on the go. I got this lean ground chicken. I plan to make either chicken patties with it or just make the chicken mince and toss it on top of some rice and some veggies. Again, with all of my protein sources, I try to stay as lean as possible with them, especially because I don't have that much fat in my macros. But again, I do need a lot of protein right now. So lean cut meats is the way to go. And speaking of like patties with the ground meat, I did also pick up these turkey burgers. So these are a little higher in fat, but they are also high in protein. So when I do need to hit my fat target, I will toss these in my air fryer and make them really quickly. I got this lean ground beef. Again, I like to either just make mince patties or just cook it on the stovetop. For my last two protein sources, these are not meat protein sources. I get liquid egg whites, and I like these because I have them in my oats or quick breakfast, zero fats, higher in protein. And I don't really consume dairy, so I don't have milk. I like to have almond milk and stuff like that. But the only dairy that I do consume is this zero fat Greek yogurt. So I like to make my protein parfaits with this. And it is higher in protein, so when I add my 1UP Nutrition protein to it, double protein power. So definitely what I like to pick up. I do cut this out though as I get closer to my show, because I stop consuming all dairy and I switch to isolate whey protein, so I'm not having the full whey protein. Next, moving on to veggies. So I like to purchase frozen veggies just because I'm able to actually eat them. Lots of the times when I purchase the fresh produce, it tends to go bad on me. And again, it's quick and easy. They're already cooked. All I gotta do is pop them in the microwave and I have fresh cooked veggies ready for me. So I picked up these asparagus spears. I also really like the rice cauliflower from Trader Joe's. So this is a great way to have a lower carb rice option. So what I would do is actually mix half of this frozen jasmine rice. They come in a little box and you just pop them in the microwave and you have ready rice. Again, quick and easy and doable. I like to mix half a portion of actual rice with the half portion of the cauliflower rice, so I have more volume for a lower amount of carbs. I also got two versions of the butternut squash. I got the zigzags and cube butternut squash. What I like to do with that is I like to spray them with olive oil, toss them in my air fryer, and have a crispy veggie to snack on. Again, they are low carb, high volume, and that's the goal when my calories are getting low. I want to make sure that I'm feeling fuller for longer and still eating a lot more food. Next, I got these marinated grilled eggplant and zucchini and pepper mix. I love the way these taste. Again, macros are bomb. The way I track it, I would just scan this just to make sure that I'm getting all the calories for that. I do track my veggies. The only vegetables that I don't track are my leafy greens and my spinaches. But yeah, I love picking up these bad boys. I either make this with the chicken or the beef. I also got these cherry tomatoes. I like to snack on them throughout the day or also toss them in a salad or on my plate just to make sure, again, I'm hitting my veggies. Last but not least, for my carb source, I love these from Trader Joe's. These are the British style crumpets. This is what they look like. So these are great for breakfast or for quick carb fix post-workout, what I do is I either toss them in the toaster and put either a little bit of jam, a little bit of peanut butter, or a little bit of honey, depending on how much carbs I wanna be consuming. Or I also put mashed raspberries instead of actual jam on them. And they are so buttery and so delicious. Zero fat as well. Highly recommend if you have a Trader Joe's near you to pick these up. So delicious. So that concludes my Trader Joe's haul for this week. Again, this is roughly what I get almost every week. I keep it simple, especially because it's easy. And I'll show you exactly how I prep some of my protein choices and how I get my food ready for the week. I highly recommend if you are trying to hit your nutrition targets, not only pre-planning your meals, but pre-prepping your meals. And it's super easy and not as time consuming. I like to dedicate about 1 to 2 hours of my weekend and prepping all of my food in advance. So during the week, all I gotta do is portion out my meals and have them all ready. So now I'm gonna take you guys along showing you how exactly I prep my food for the week. All right, so I'm about to start my weekly bulk prep. And I usually just pre-prep my protein sources and keep most of my veggies to do the day of. So today I'm gonna be prepping some chicken breast, some lean ground chicken, and a leaner ground beef. And I'll show you exactly how I do that. So I'm gonna be making the chicken breast in the oven. And these are the three spices that I usually use for all of my meats. This is a Dominate sugar and salt-free limitless spice. This is my coach's spice range, so if you guys are interested to purchase that, I'll put that link in my bio. And then I like to do onion salt and this salt-free lemon pepper. They're the basics that I like to put on all of my meat. And also another quick tip to save calories and excess fats, I always cook with a cooking spray, and I am using the high heat formula just so it doesn't smoke or burn in the oven. So what I'm gonna do is take my chicken breast. And I am not cutting them because I am going to be slow cooking them in the oven on a lower temperature heat. And I am going to place them on my little tray. So I'm going to spray the chicken breast with the cooking spray and then generously season it. I do not hold back on my seasonings until I do get a little closer to prep, and I only use the Dominate spice range just because it is salt and sugar free. Just like that. So then you're gonna flip it. Make sure we have seasoning on all sides. And last but not least, before I pop them in the oven, I give it an extra spray. And I'm gonna have my temperature of my oven to about 370 degrees because I am slow cooking them. And I'm gonna cook them a little bit uncovered, and then halfway through throw a little bit of water and continue cooking them. All right, so next I'm gonna be prepping the ground chicken. This is a leaner cut for chicken. It's 8% fat. And what I'm going to do with this, instead of just cooking it on the stovetop, is I'm actually gonna make meatballs with them and put them in my air fryer. And I have the Ninja air fryer. I'll also link that in my description if you guys are interested in purchasing that. So what I'm going to do is, it is defrosted fully. I'm going to season it right in the tray because I will be mixing it with my hands and creating the little sausage patties before putting them in the air fryer. Again, I'm using the same seasonings and applying a generous amount as I will be mixing it in with my hands. So I just grab it and I mix it all in, making sure that there is seasoning throughout the entire meat. Next, what I'm gonna do is create decently sized patties. I will weigh them cooked when I am tracking them. So we're gonna continue making the little patties. I don't add anything to them just because it's a little easier for me to track when I just have them cooked. So now what I'm going to do is take my cooking spray and spray the lined air fryer tray. And I'm just going to place as many as I can evenly spaced. It does cook pretty fast, so even if you can't cook them all at the same time, it doesn't take as long. And so after I place them evenly, what I'm going to do is pop them in my air fryer, click the air fry button, and I usually cook them at 390. And I do it for about 20 minutes, but I do check them halfway and flip them over. Since I'm already making patties with the chicken, ground chicken, I am going to just be cooking the mince on here on the stovetop. So I'm having that preheated right now, and I am using a 4% fat ground beef. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spray my pan and throw in the ground meat. And once I put that onto the stovetop, I'm going to break it up a little bit before I season. So when I do cook my meat minces on the stovetop, I like to cook them a little before cooking the spices. The only reason for that is I don't like when my spices get a little bit burnt on the stovetop. So while all my protein sources are cooking, I like to cook one or two of my vegetable sources. And this is microwavable, and that's why I really like getting these frozen ones. So the microwave instruction says to make sure that I am putting the spheres onto a nice dish and then popping them in the microwave. So all I do is I'm going to pop them in the microwave like so. I do add a little bit of oil and pop a little bit of seasoning. So while it is microwaving, the flavors infuse with the veggies. And it's simple as popping it in and boom. So this is what I have prepped up. I have my asparagus that's cooked and seasoned. I have my ground beef that I cooked on the skillet. I have my chicken patties that I made in the air fryer and slow cooked roasted chicken breast. So these are gonna be my main sources of protein for the next few days. And if I use any other veggies, I'm gonna cook them fresh. I also wanted to show you what else I was gonna have for protein. So I'm gonna have these tuna packets, some egg whites for breakfast, and of course some 1UP Nutrition coconut ice cream whey protein to make sure that I'm hitting all my macro targets for the rest of the week. And that concludes today's video. If you guys like my WBFF prep series, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I will be posting weekly prep videos, and thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed.